Hello, I'm Selma Teacher 7, also known as Mr. Barry by my students. Today I want to look at setting up a new Samsung network printer. Now the Samsung printer that I'll be using today is also Google Cloud ready or print ready, so that I can print straight from my Chromebooks to the printer. So let's see how to set it up. This is the Samsung printer that I received from an eBay purchase. And to set it up, what I did was I plugged in the power, and I also plugged in a network cable from the printer to my Wi-Fi router. And so I did that. Now, since then, I did this is a wireless printer or Wi-Fi printer, so I'll take you step by step on setting that up. What do you get with it? Well, you get a quick user guide. Shows you how to set it up wirelessly, which is nice. You also get a CD with drivers that you install for your Windows machine. And you can see there, this is a Samsung C410 series, and yes, it is a color laser printer. Now, when I first received this, what I did was, besides putting in paper, I also opened it up here. So here's the little tab, you press that down, and there's our print cartridges. You have the black toner and then the color toners on top. And I just wanted to make sure that they were seated properly. Then I closed it. I turned on the power. And that's the power button there. And then it checks everything. So that takes a few seconds. And green light. So everything's going well here. Good. So let's go to the computer and see how to set
this up. Okay, first off, what you want to do is download the printer manager, and you can get that from Samsung.com, or you can just get it from the CD that came with your printer. Now, what I did was I downloaded the newest version from Samsung's website, and what I downloaded was the Samsung Easy Printer Manager. And then with the printer, I turned the printer on and I connected the printer physically with the network. This was before I had set up the Wi-Fi. I just wanted to make sure it was fully connected. Then I click over here, I click on add, and there it is. So I say yes, add this printer to my selection here. There it is. Now it's been added, and I can look at the device settings, and I'm going to go through the sync through web service, which I'll show you here in a moment, and exactly what that is. You go back here to home, but right away you can see your toner cartridges, the toner remaining on those, and other information about it. I've already gone in and customized this information. But one thing that you want to take note of is the IP address of your printer. And it's right here, it's under IP address. Now, why is that important? Well, this address right here is important because you open up your web browser, like your Chrome web browser, you key in this address, and that takes you right to this printer's, basically, you might say homepage, or where all of its settings are located. And that's where we'll be going right here in a moment. So here I am on the web browser, and I keyed in that address, the 192.168.0.130. Now when I went there, it went through the what's called the sync through web service, and it comes up. There's no alerts on it, and it tells you like the host name and other information in here. what we're going to do is I'm going to show you how to set it up on your wireless network. And what you need to do is, of course, you need to click here on login. So let me log out first of all. And this is what you'd see at first. Nothing is changeable. You're just at the website, the IP address for your printer. You see a picture of your printer. You see some of its name, like the model name and other things. But you really can't make changes. You need to log in. So you click on login and you type in admin, and the default password is SEC, and then there's five zeros. You log in, and now you see more options here. You see a lot more options. For example, there are settings and then network settings. Let's go into those now. And these settings are, you can go in there and click on and change them. But if you notice down here, it says wireless. So I'm going to click on wireless here and then go into the wireless settings. And I made sure that my wireless was enabled. And then I went in and I clicked on wizard. And what it does is it opens up and it says, oh, look, I found these SSIDs. I found these networks in your area. Which one is yours? So you click on one. And then you say next. And then you type in the password for your network. Okay, now after you've typed in your security password for your network, you say next, and it's going to connect, and then you click on apply. There you have it. Now this printer is connected wirelessly, and you can unplug the cables that you had on it, and it really is that easy. So that's the first setup here. Now you also have what's called Google Cloud Print, and here's the name of the printer. And once you're here at this page, you need to click on register. So you click on register. Okay. After a moment or two, it says your selections have been modified successfully. Alrighty. Now make sure that you are connected to, you're logged into your Google account first of all, and when you do this, but of course, you know that. All right, so now it says registration, finish printer registration. Okay, so go ahead and push the finish printer registration on the pop-up window, which I did already. And there you are. So it really is that easy to set up your printers now on Google Cloud Print. I hope this has helped you. Thank you very much.